Hello everyone, I'm Zhao Dapeng. I come from Beihang University. The research field of our paper is 3D face reconstruction. What is our paper discuss? Over the past few years, single view 3D face reconstruction methods can produce beautiful 3D models. Nevertheless, the input of these works is unobtracted faces. We describe a system designed to reconstruct convincing face texture in the case of occlusion. Motivated by the present facial features, we propose a complete face present map generation method guided by landmarks. We estimate the 2D face structure of the reasonable position of the occlusion R, which is used for the construction of 3D texture. An excellent anti-occlusion face reconstruction method should ensure the authenticity of the output, including the topological structure between the eyes, nose, and mouse. We extensively test our method and its components qualitatively, demonstrating the reliability of our estimated facial structure. We conduct extensive experiments on general 3D face reconstruction tasks as concrete examples to demonstrate the method's superior occlusion ability over existing methods often break down. We further provide numerous quantitative examples showing that our method advances both the quality and the robustness of 3D face reconstruction and occlusion since. The research background of our work. 3D face reconstruction refers to synthesizing a 3D face model giving one input face photo. It has a wide range of applications, such as face recognition and digital entertainment. The reconstruction task is challenging as human face a structure partly invisibility when considering occluded scenes. We cannot use artificial intelligence to robustly predict the 3D texture of the occluded eye of the face. On the other hand, when faces are partly occluded, existing methods often indiscriminately reconstruct the occluded eye with the assistance of prism map. We found a way to understand the occluded eye and reconstruct the input image to a reasonable 3D face model. We found that existing methods mainly concentrate on obstructed face. When encountering occluded scenes, this method often fails. So our goal is how to reconstruct the face under occluded scenes. We designed a two-stage method for 3D face reconstruction. At the stage 1, we reconstruct a 2D face with complete facial features at first. Function of landmark prediction. The architecture game aims to generate landmarks from an original face image. When we get 6-8 feature points,
let me be clear the loss function. since we want to focus more on efficiency and follow with present map generation task, we built a sufficiently effective NLM key upon the mobile net V3. NLM key is focused on feature extraction, unlike traditional landmark detectors. The final model is realized by fully connecting the fused feature maps. We set loss function loss LM key as follows. Loss LM key is equal to Z LM key minus ZGT, where ZGT donates the eyes drawn to the face landmarks.
We connect these points, then we get a face present map M beta. We can get M alpha by traditional face present task. The final map M gamma need M alpha plus M beta. This part can refer to algorithm 1. In the section of face image, we design a encoder-decoder network to produce the final 2D face. It is worth mentioning that where we use the SFT layer. So,
it is changing to generate a realistic face with the original face image and the modified prism map to keep the face in the unoccluded R as it is. We use CGAN. To benefit from the piece-to-piece architecture, we propose a face image synthesis network, NET, which was based on piece-to-piece HD as a backbone. FRSN receive iFace and mAlpha as input. To fuse the R-face and M-alpha, we use the spatial feature transformer layer learned a mapping function M that outputs a parameter pair gamma and beta. Based on the previous condition percent from the feature M-alpha, a pair of affine transformation parameters gamma and beta model the percent where the mapping equation can be expressed as gamma and beta is equal to m percent.
And then let us talk about the camera and the illumination model. Given an face image, we adopt the BFM model after the 3D face is reconstructed. It can be projected onto the image plane with the perspective projection. V is equal to F times PR times R times S and plus T, where V2D donates the projection function that turns the 3D model into a 2D face positions. F donates the scale factor, PR donates the projection matrix, and R donates the rotation matrix. SMOD donates the shape of the face, and T2D donates the transition factor. So now our mission is transformed into 3D reconstruction from the frontal face. We designed a weakly supervised framework based on deep learning method to generate a final 3D face model. We began to analyze the result of our experiment. As shown in the figure, we compare the result with others. It is very obvious that in the first line, you will clearly find that other reconstruction method all gives wrong result.
Please look at the figure. The last two columns shows our result. The main columns demonstrate the result of 3DDFA, DF2Net, and Chen. Quantitative result shows that our method surpasses other methods. The figure shows that our method can contract a complete face model and occlusion scenes such as glasses, children, palms, and hair. Other methods focus on generating high resolution face textures. These frameworks cannot effectively deal with occluded scenes. The figure shows the comparison result on the MRCC Forest dataset. MRCC Forest dataset is a 3D face dataset that contains 53 faces with their ground truth models. We artificially add some occlusions as input. We calculated the average 90% largest error between the generative model and the ground truth model. The figure shows that our method can effectively handle occlusion.
Next, as shown in the figure, is our quantitative comparison result. To fully support the application of our method to occluded face image, we test our system on the LFW dataset.
The figure shows our test result. Our choice of using the resize 50 to regress the shape computations is motivated by the unique robustness to extreme viewing conditions.
In summary, we propose a novel algorithm that combines feature points and face pricing map to generate a face with complete face features. To address the problem with invisible face error and occluded scenes, we propose standardizing input force photo based on scan network rather than reconstructing 3D face directly. Our future work includes combining our method with transformer architecture to further improve accuracy. This is the acknowledgement section. This paper is supported by National Natural Science Foundation of China, National Key Research and Development Program of China, the Key Area Research and Development Program of Guangdong Province, and the Leading Talents in Innovation and Entrepreneurship of Qingdao. That's all. Thank you for your attention.